conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many times there are emails floating around. There is one which shows the grave of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Where? That which has been sent is the grave of Jalaluddin Rumi in Turkey. Go and Google it and see. There are no photographs whatsoever of the Qabr Sharif of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nothing. No. Not even one. Nothing. It's sealed completely. It is covered with lead. There's nothing, no sign from inside or outside. No. Nothing. Now people get excited and the emails do their rounds. Then they have another one. House of Khadija radiallahu anha. House of Fatima radiallahu anha. This. Where did they get all this from? Allahu Akbar. Imagine the latest camera with a color picture with a resolution far greater than the passport photos we have, and they want to say this is a home in the 1400 years ago. Whose camera were they using? Allahu Akbar. And we say subhanallah, we start crying and we forward the message and we write at the bottom, if you don't send it to 10 people you're going to suffer. A'udhu billah. Wallahi, it's a fact. Look at this. And our iman goes higher and lower because of photos that these people are making a fool of us of. Way. And the Muslims are the biggest prey to this type of activity. One wonders why. Maybe shaitan operates in a very professional way when it comes to us, because he knows we have iman. May Allah safeguard us. Remember one thing, I always tell people, we want to look at signs. You know, they tell you, look at the clouds, it says Allah. When I was young, I'd seen Father Christmas in the clouds also. Wallahi, it's a fact. If the Quran, which is the living miracle, cannot move you, what do you think is going to move you? These false signs around you? Allahu Akbar. If Allah says, اِقْتَرَبَتِ السَّاعَةُ وَانْشَقَّ الْقَمَرُ, when Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam pointed at the moon, it split in two. If that doesn't raise your hair, you think a small beetroot written Allah on it is going to move you? When the Hindus use the same beetroot and say, no, it's written Om on it. Wallahi, it's a fact. So if that was evidence that your deen is correct, then what about all the Hindus and Christians and everyone else who've brought even more clear evidence to show you they've also got rotis and they've also got, you know, tomatoes and so on, where their God's names are written. So if that is the evidence of a religion being correct, where you're supposed to look for tomatoes and rotis and eggplants and so on and vegetables, then what happens to the Quran? Are we putting it on one side? Look at how shaitan comes to us. We have the most powerful gift. When you read and understand the Quran, you will shake. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. The true believers are those whom when Allah is mentioned, they tremble. And when the verses of the Quran are recited,